Face-to-face classes on early 2022, Ikakasa na. Memo on preparation for the pilot face-to-face classes, expansion and transitioning to the new normal, inilabas ng DepEd. Inilabas ang DepEd Memorandum No. 85 Series of 2021 on preparations for the implementation of the expanded phase of face-to-face classes. According to the memo, the pilot implementation of the limited face-to-face classes for basic education commenced on November 15, 2021 and various dates thereafter. These schools underwent rigorous preparations in accordance with the standards set forth in the Department of Education and Department of Health Joint Memorandum Circular No. 1, Series of 2021 or the Operational Guidelines on the Implementation of Limited Face-to-Face Learning Modality. The assessment of the pilot implementation will provide insights and experience on implementing face-to-face classes while adhering to the minimum health and safety protocols to prevent the transmission of COVID-19. Parallel to this, DepEd issued DepEd Memorandum No. 71 Series of 2021 titled Preparations for the Pilot Face-to-Face, Expansion and Transitioning to the New Normal, which instructed schools to conduct self-assessment using the school safety assessment tool to assess their readiness to face-to-face classes and to identify areas of support for the expansion of the implementation of face-to-face classes and towards the transition to the new normal. As part of the further preparations for the implementation of the expanded phase of face-to-face classes targeted to commence in early 2022, all public and private schools nationwide shall start preparation for face-to-face classes. Specifically, the schools shall first, prepare all the requirements for the safe implementation of limited face-to-face classes in line with the standards set in DepEd and DOH Joint Memorandum Circular No. 1, Series of 2021. Second, set up the physical structures, wash facilities and supplies, personal protective equipment, health and safety protocols, learning materials, class programs, and human resource requirements as required in the Joint Memorandum Circular. Third, conduct coordination meetings at the local level with concerned government agencies, partners, and community members to discuss their respective participation in the limited face-to-face classes. Fourth, secure free, prior, and informed consent with necessary documentation for schools in IP communities. Fifth, involve the community in the school reopening process and ensure local coordination mechanisms with Barangay Health Emergency Response Team and local government units for referral system, contact tracing, school traffic management, disinfection, contingency school lockdown, and among others. Sixth, coordinate with LGUs to fast-track vaccination of teachers, school personnel, and eligible learners and their household members. 7. Strengthen advocacy and campaign programs for vaccination of teachers and eligible learners. 8. Adjust class programs according to their alternative work arrangements and conduct an orientation of teaching personnel on possible changes in their AWA. 9. Set up mechanisms to respond to mental health concerns of learners and teachers. 10. Plan for the orientation of learners, parents, guardians, teaching and non-teaching personnel, external stakeholders and LGU of the eligibility for participation, existing protocols, mechanisms, and procedures needed in conducting face-to-face classes. Orientation shall take place at least 2 weeks prior to the conduct of face-to-face classes to allow parents, guardians, help children to mentally and emotionally adapt and cope with the transition. During the orientation, the school shall observe the health and safety protocols and, lastly, simulate the implementation protocols among school personnel to identify possible implementation issues and discuss possible scenarios during the actual conduct of face-to-face classes. For the private schools that intend to implement limited face-to-face classes, school administrators are requested to submit the following documents to the Office of the Regional Director. First, letter of intent addressed to the regional director stating the objectives, expected outcomes, and commitment to observe the minimum health and safety protocols as stipulated in DepEd and DOH Joint Memorandum Circular No. 1, Series of 2001. Second, implementation plan including the timelines following the four components of the operational framework, namely, first, safe operations, second, teaching and learning, third, including the most marginalized, and fourth, well-being and protection. Next is contingency plan showing action points to address contingencies that might occur during implementation, and lastly, accomplished SS80 showing compliance to all elements of the tool. To support the preparations of the schools, the regional offices and schools division offices shall A. Provide technical assistance to schools based on the gaps and challenges identified in the SS80 results of the schools. B. Prepare an implementation plan for the conduct of limited face-to-face classes in the respective regions and schools divisions. C. Mobilize resources to meet the health and safety standards and protocols. D. Orient school heads, LGUs, and key officials on the standards of the implementation of the face-to-face classes. E. Include the Health and Nutrition Coordinator and IP Education Coordinator in the composite team to provide technical assistance to schools on health and nutrition and IP education concerns respectively. F. Coordinate with LGUs to fast-track vaccination of teachers and school personnel and eligible learners. G. Strengthen advocacy and campaign programs for vaccination of teachers and eligible learners. H. Conduct training and technical assistance to ensure the protocols and standards are met prior to the opening of schools for face-to-face classes. And I. Ensure that schools are linked to appropriate government agencies for the establishment of the respective referral system. Expanded phase shall already cover all grade levels from K to 12. At yan po ang ating balita ngayong araw regarding sa napapalapit na pagbubukas ng face-to-face classes sa lahat ng level ngayong January 2022. Sana nga po'y maging okay at makasali ng schools ng ating mga anak. Kung nagustuhan niyo ang aming content, pasuyo namang pakilike ng video at huwag kalimutang mag-subscribe at i-hit ang notification bell para updated kayo sa aming mga posts.